I'm back for probably, you could consider it another technical part of singing lesson, and it's going to be dealing with vowels. But before we get into the actual proper vowels part, we will discuss other things. First, I think it's very good for your confidence, and it's very good to see the way your mouth is positioned if you get a mirror and you do this in front of a mirror. So today we're doing singing dictation, which is the clarity in the pronunciation of your lyrics. Now remember, I've said to you before, your talking voice is not your singing voice. How you pronounce, how your mouth is positioned is all different when you sing. So as I said, it's good to practice in front of a mirror. Now, we'll do a very simple thing first before I get into the proper vowel exercises, which is a bit different to A, E, I, O, U, which I'll explain before later. So let's just sing the vowels anyway. A, E, I, O, U. Now you can sing them on the same level if you want. A, E, I, O, U. Or you can go A, E, I, O, U. Muck around with it. A, E, I, O, U. 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 But that's not the vowels that I'm going to teach you to practice, because the vowels I'm going to teach you to practice all have to do with mouth placement. Anyway, let's say aloud the consonants together. So we're left with B, D, C, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z, or C, depending on what country you're in. Because I'm English, I say tong, and I mean, which is some in Australia say tongue. Now, just sidetracking a bit, the Australian accent, which is quite nasal, is actually derived from Cockney, London, which is just something trivial for you. Anyway, let's practice. This is good for breathing as well. So let's try and see if we can hold our breath. So let's sit back and do the consonants and hold our breath going B, D, C, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. I only just managed to do that, but you could play around with it again. B, D, C, F, G, H, G, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now, I'm just going to be really funny. Tongue twisters are a really good way of practicing things. I got really good at this one. It's an English one. How does it go? Oh, I'll come back to it later. I was about peep. Oh, that's right. Peter Pie picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers, Peter Pie picked. If Peter Pie picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's a peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? But I got really good at that because I used to practice from the age of 10, and so I can say it really fast. But here's some other tongue twisters. She sells seashells by the seashore. Some of these are really funny when you start to say them really fast. Which wrist watches are Swiss wrist watches? Try saying that fast. I haven't heard this one before. I got it off the internet. I'm going to just have a go and you can have a laugh at me. Which wrist watches are Swiss watches? And so it's which wrist watches are Swiss wrist watches? And this one, I remember at school having a laugh. I slit the sheet I slit, and the slitted sheet I sit. It ends up being shit. You end up. So practice that. I'll say them again for you. She sells seashells by the seashore. That's pretty simple. Which wrist watches are Swiss wrists? Watches. I slit the sheet I slit, and the slitted sheet I sit. As I said, you say that last one fast enough and you end up with shit. The other thing is, oh, here's another one. If a gumball can boil oil, how much oil can a gumball boil if a gumball can boil oil? That's really good for the oi. And we want to practice vowels. Oi. If a gumball can boil oil, how much oil can a gumball boil if a gumball can boil oil? You got oi. Rounded. When you get your lyrics, it's a good idea. I teach my students to actually, this is also good for storytelling, is to, before you start singing the song, to read aloud the song. So read the words, and it's a good idea to actually break those words up into syllables. That helps too. Now, I said before, exercise the whole mouth with tongue trills, lip buzzes, and hum tunes. So lip buzzes. Hum tunes. Now, why are vowels important? Vowels in a song are important because vowels are mostly what carries the tune. Now, there are when you're doing exercises, the five primary vowels in singing are R, E, E, O, and U. That's A, E, E, O, and U. Now try singing them. A, E, E, O, U. Did you see how my lips change? I'll try it again for you. You can practice, if you are a classical thing and you like to do it to scales, you can do it to scales, like A, E, E, O, U. A, E, E, O, U. A, E, E, O, U. So you relax your lips and enunciate each vowel with your tongue tucked behind your bottom back teeth. Please, don't sing vowels the same way you speak. You say words in a talking voice and try singing them and you'll notice the difference. I will come back to the tongue before. I'm just going to show you. Remember I said about the mirror? So these are the vowels here that I want you to do. See? That's A, E, E, O, U. A, E, E, O, U. A, E, E, O, U. And get the faster and faster. Now, there are some words that we can sing with this R. You make your mouth into an oval shape, and the words are hot, not, brought, fall, father, amen, call, doll, taught, ball. But notice how that sounds different in my talking voice. I will sing it for you. Hot, not, brought, fall, father, amen, call, doll, taught, ball. Notice how my mouth was all oval, and I'll just show you. Hopefully you can see the top bit there. Those are the words. Now let's go to the E. So practice in the mirror, met, met. Lips in to the E. And you should feel light vibrations just above the lip and the nose. So the words are met, set, wet, get, let, bet, pet, fret, blend, and bend. But when you sing them, it's completely different, because when I said them just then, I didn't have the vibrations. But let's sing them. Met, set, wet, get, let, bet, pet, fret, blend, bend. I'll show you. Hopefully you can see. You probably can see all the words, so you're going to get all the idea there. I'll just show, go over so you can see. And see the top two as well. Then we have E. E. See how I'm smiling? So the vibrations with the E. Now, apparently E is a very popular one to do to scales. So E is very good. You go E, 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 E. See how I smile? Now it's E as in meat, sweet, feet, leave, she, he, be, see, and we. But listen to the difference. You'll note, say, what I'm trying to say to you is say the words aloud and then sing them, and you'll notice the difference. Don't forget you'll have the mirror in front of you. So it's meet, sweet, feet, leave, she, he, be, see, we. Okay, then we have O. O. With the round O. So your mouth is round. So it's so, no, ho, though, foe, blow, no, cold, broke. I'll again put it up there for you. Hopefully you can see it. Put it a bit higher. So I'm not singing to scales. I'm just playing around with my voice here. So, no, ho, though, fo, blow, no, cold, broke. So, no, ho, though, fo, blow. And then we have ooh. And you pucker up as if you're kissing. Ooh, as in blue. And here are the words, and I'll sing them again for you in a minute. We'll say the words together. So the words are blue, to, new, do, moo, moon, June, tune, balloon, room, coo, cool. So, blue, to, new, do, Moo, moon, June, June, balloon, broom, coo, cool. See how I puckered? So I'll just do the first few for you. Blue, two, mew, cool. See? Pucker sound. So there's your little thing. There's the vowels when you're looking in your mirror. And I'll just very quickly show you the words again. That's how to pronounce them up the top. Okay. Now, an important word about the tongue, or tongue, as Australians say, tongue, whatever. Problems occur when the tongue is pulled back, which blocks sound, or when the tongue is too tense. For the most part of singing, the tongue should lay flat and relaxed. I hope to do some more things with you, you know, some more sounds. Even I can hear my own English accent coming out. People know that I'm not quite Australian because I say some words with a bit of an accent, but I came out to Australia when I was nearly 7, so I have lost much of my accent. It's just my ow, oos are a bit more pronounced. And like, I'll give you another example. A poem. That's how Australians, and other countries will pronounce poem, you know. I wrote a poem. For me, it's poem. And I'll just give you an example. I'm going to say something with an accent. My father walked in to the shop one day and he went, bottle cork, please. And I had to go in and say, he wants a bottle of Coke, please. A bottle of cork, please. So we're all unique, but whatever accent you have, the vowels are important. And this is part one of a technical. Remember again, I am not going to be teaching you classical or scales, but pronunciation in singing, if you're not clear when what you're saying, you not only, it doesn't matter how badly or how well you sing, if you're not clear or you're not telling the story well, you will lose your audience. So you have to sing. And I'm going to end with another song to teach you right now, and it's very easy. Maiden, maiden, can you explain what can grow without snow or rain? What can burn for endless years? And what can weep but shed no tears? The chorus. Tomba la tomba la tomba la laika. Tomba la tomba la tomba la laika. Tomba la laika. Play ba la laika. Tomba la laika. Laugh and be gay. Second verse. Idle lad, you're joking, I know. A stone can grow without rain or snow. Love can burn for endless years. A heart can weep but shed no tears. Chorus. Tomba la tomba la tomba la laika. Tomba la tomba. Tomba la laika, tomba la laika, play ba la laika, tomba la laika, laugh and be gay. I hope you enjoyed that. That was actually a gypsy song that we were taught Oh, probably 50 years ago. So it's a pretty easy song for you to sing. Just replay over and over. And I'll teach you. I'll sing Amazing Grace, but there's many varieties of Amazing Grace, but not today. Thank you for letting me have a sing, because as I said before, I'm teaching you guys to sing, and it's also allowing me to be able to sing. Now, these lessons aren't going to come out too fast, because before you know it, I'll be done, and that'll be the end of that, and then I've lost my passion and I don't know what to do. I'll be back to going, oh, what can I do next? If you have a suggestion for me, or want to get together or look together to doing singing with me, and you live in the area, please leave a comment below. I live on the Sunshine Coast. I have quite good bus opportunities, but I don't like to be late at night. So, hey, and I'm open to going to teach people to sing. It's not an idea that people come to my home, because it's a one bedroom unit, and we have this complex is for over 55 years old, so they don't want to be bothered by people singing. This is why I try and do most of my videos during the day, and I'm getting on as well. Anyway, I hope you have a lovely afternoon. Take care. Thanks for watching. Bye, love. Bye.